What's up, guys? So, we have an epidemic going on.
DDS.
I guess it's an epidemic. I'm not really going to say that it's... I don't even know what to say, if it's like good or bad or what. I don't even know. But there are a lot of women nowadays just now supposedly realizing that they're bisexual. If y'all been following this channel for any length of time, you know I did like a random jibba jabba video on it like last year, I think, talking about how I was supposedly in love with Dej Loaf at the time. Of course that crush has been passed. It's gone, well, somewhat. I'm not really infatuated over her anymore. I still like her and whatnot, and her music and stuff, but I'm not like overly obsessed anymore. However, I thought those feelings that I briefly had for women were like gonna go away. I thought it was a stage. However, it is not a stage. I'm gonna find out that it wasn't, so I can't believe I'm making a video about this, but I didn't want to do it the traditional way and call it a coming out story. I didn't want to do that because it would seem like I'm calling more attention to myself on YouTube, and I don't want to do that. I don't want to do that. I'm just making this video because I just feel like it and I want to raise awareness about this issue. So, basically it wasn't a stage for me. Now, what happened last year, around the time, like I said, with the Dej Loaf thing, I told my husband, I forgot how the conversation came up. We were talking about, I think he came in from work or whatever. We were laughing about something. We were talking about something, you know, neutral. And then somehow it came up, we were talking about crushes, because we were making fun of each other, saying, you know, there was something along the line of having, like, crushes. Recently, we were talking about that, and at the time, I was like, I don't know if I was already starting to work, because I had a job, had a part-time job last year at this place up the street, so I was kind of, you know, a little bit happier, like in a little happier state of mind at the time, whatever, and I was listening to Deja's music nonstop and all that stuff, so I kind of told him that I had, like, a little crush on Dej Loaf. And of course, you know, at first he kind of laughed it off. Because it was like, what? You know, it's a woman. You know, how? But, I said that. And it was, kind of a roller coaster ride at first. It took a minute for him to realize what was happening or what I was saying. And even I was confused about the whole thing. And it's a long story. Pretty much, we kind of struggled at first over that. You know, being the fact, like, you know, basically he thought I was gonna leave him for a woman when I first told him this, but at the time I was like, you know what, this has gotta be just a stage, you know, like, I can't possibly be lesbian or bisexual at all. But as time went on, like, I would say probably the beginning of this year, when the Dej Loaf thing pretty much went out of commission, like, my crush wasn't as strong anymore, I pretty much realized that this was not going away. Like, I would start literally looking at women and get turned on. And I can't say this is the first time this happened. This is not the first time this has happened at all. It's definitely not. And I had to actually recall anything that might have actually made me turn this way. And I thought, okay, maybe it's because of my abuse. But I'm like, how would it be because of my abuse? Even though people take things differently, you know, people get abused in different ways and they take it differently, and you never know how you're gonna turn out. Like, some women, they get abused and they hate men to where they definitely go towards a woman, and some people, they love men or they become promiscuous. Some don't want nothing to do with men at all. You know, there's a bunch of different scenarios. Anyway, when I realized that these feelings were not going away, I actually had to dig back and think about any other time that this might have actually started to take root. And I remembered back in college when me and my husband were dating, I used to actually look at women, like, you know, I would look at their butts or whatever, and I would point them out to him. You know, it's kind of like a joke, like, ooh, look at her. Yeah, Kayana. This child is not going to be quiet, let me talk. So yeah, I remember back in college I used to do that, and I did that for a long time. I don't even know why I did that. And he got worried because he was like, okay, what do you want me to do? Do you want me to go after another woman and cheat on you? And I kept saying no, of course. I was just like, you know, well, you know, I would just talk about women. So, yeah, I used to do that back then. And he got worried that I wanted him to cheat on me. And I said, no, that wasn't the case. I couldn't even explain why I like doing that, why I like looking at women. And I would tell him to look for some dumb reason. But, yeah, that's what I did. And it never actually occurred to me that I might have been bi or anything. It never ever occurred to me. I didn't even think like that at all. It just didn't occur to me. So, fast forward again to now. Yeah, like I said, in the beginning we struggled with this new discovery of mine. We're just now settling it in terms of, okay, he knows I'm not going to leave him. And that's that. However, the reason why I said this is a pandemic is because I'm not the only one feeling like this. There are thousands of women who are married and they want a woman. They just suddenly become bi, or it seems like they suddenly just became bi out of nowhere. And I'm like, okay, there's got to be some reason to that. So, if y'all know me, I try to look into the deeper reason behind everything, because there is a deeper reason behind why people do what they do or why people come across things. And I realize the deeper reason, of course, pretty obvious. To me it is. To me it's like fucking obvious at this point. Is that the reason why women are wanting other women sexually is because they are lonely as fuck. So most women don't really have friendships the way they need to have friendships, or the way they wish.
Girl, could you hush?
Hush, little one. Most women, they just don't have friends anymore. And, you know, some women, they have friends, or they have, like, maybe one or two. I have none. You know, y'all know I have no friends. So I think the big reason behind all these women suddenly becoming bi or suddenly craving a woman's attention so bad is because, again, there's, like, no sisterhood. You know, sometimes I think I was born the wrong time frame, because there's no close-knit anything anymore. There's no family around. I don't have any friends. You know, most women shun me for being a stay-home mom. They don't understand me. They don't want to understand me. They can't do what I do. They don't want to do what I do, blah, blah, blah. They don't even take time to understand me at all. You know, and I'm just so different compared to the average black woman out here. I just am. I'm a geek. You know, I'm pretty much an atheist. I'm a lot of things. So, I don't get much, you know, favor in that. So, I haven't had any friends ever. Like, ever since probably high school, because I was so overprotected in high school, I didn't really have many friends then, or if I did, I wasn't able to keep up with them, so they drifted off. I didn't have any friends in college, except my husband, because he was the only one there for me. And once I found him, I pretty much damn near clung to him, and that's that. And even up to now, you know, I talk to a lot of people online or whatnot, and they're just not really interested in talking to me. They're not really interested in hanging with me at all. And I'm the nicest person alive. Yeah, I know I am. But, again, I haven't had any friends. There's no sisterhood. There's no bonding. Me and my mother are not close. Me and my sister, it's sometimes there. But we're not as close as we used to be, because we're grown and we're like years apart, and some things it just seems kind of awkward to talk about. Or, you know, it'll probably get there one day, but, you know, time. So with me, I have no womanly figure around me. I have no one to, I'm not saying I'm looking for someone to look up to. No, that's not what I'm looking for. I'm looking for just genuine friendship. But I don't have that. I've never had that. I've just been going for years without any mommy friends, any kind of friends around me. And it's been soul-crushing. It's a very, very lonely journey. And again, it's an epidemic, because a lot of women, married women, are going through this. Even some women who are not married, they're just seeking they're seeking female attention so hard to where, yeah, it has become sexual. And that might sound crazy to a lot of people who don't understand this, because I never thought I would be, like, considered a part of the gay community. You know, before I wasn't really too keen into LGBT rights or anything. I used to kind of fluff that off, like, you know what, I don't want any part of that. You know, I'll support you if I know you, but I'm not going to your parades and stuff. No. And I never thought that I'd actually become a part of it. But again, it is what it is. There's an epidemic. Probably just the same with men, too. I mean, men, there's no brotherhoods anymore, either. That's our men are turning gay. Men want male companionship, and these days, nowadays, you can't... Can't fucking talk. These days, you can't really get that anywhere. Everybody's too selfish. Everyone's busy. Everyone's fucking working all the time. There's no closeness. No one's hardly close anymore. There's just too much fighting. There's too much, oh man, I don't like you because you don't have money. There's just too much of that. And I'm just honestly annoyed of it. So technically, that's the reason why people are just now becoming bisexual. Some people were like that as kids. Some people were actually born that way. I can't say I was born that way. I don't really know. I just know mine stemmed. Mostly stemmed from me just being lonely. Very, very lonely all this time. I have no woman who wants to get close to me at all. You know, on any level. I just don't. So, hey, it happened. I can't really control it, and it makes a lot of sense. You can't really not hurt someone. You can't really judge someone for becoming this way if you kind of get it. I mean, hey, you might be in the same situation to where you're very, very lonely. And you just have no one to, I mean, everyone wants to bond with someone of the same sex in some way. But again, I just don't have that, so. And again, I think I might have been, you know, actually bisexual a long time ago. I just refused to acknowledge it at the time. Because I was still, you know, halfway Christian at the time. And I just said no at all by any cost. I pretty much put it out of my head completely. So, yeah. Wow, my hair is looking weird. Oh, well. yeah, pretty much put it out of my head, period. Man, I can't believe I'm talking about this. However, I already put it out there. I've already been talking about this stuff on Instagram and whatnot. Talking about, you know, wanting to find a woman to add to our family, pretty much. And, you know, my husband, he doesn't mind because, well, actually, he doesn't mind more so now because we've talked about it. We've gotten closer because of it. We've, you know, kind of bonded over this in a way. It's a weird way. You know, it's hard to explain. However, he's always been interested in harems, like harem animes, you know, where there's more than one woman around. But, you know, I think it kind of fits into what we're going for right now. So, okay, I don't know where I'm going with the rest of this conversation. However, I'm just making that statement. Yeah, it is a real epidemic that a lot of married women, or women period, are seeking sisterhood so bad to where it turns sexual in a way to where you look at a woman and you just, for some reason, you want everything about her. Like, you want... the emotional part, you want the sexual part, you just want to just kiss her, you want to grab her, you want to do everything to her. Y'all, you just want to be that close to a woman because you just don't feel that for some reason. You want that bond so bad. And I do. I want that bond so bad to where, no, I would not care to have a woman in bed with me. Like, seriously. So again, I didn't want to make this the traditional coming out story, and is not the traditional coming out story. I don't really care anymore. I mean, this world's all fucked up. Everyone's sleeping with everybody. Everyone wants a family. Everyone is trying to create their own family by whatever means. It doesn't even matter what race you are, what sex you are, you know, and nothing. It doesn't even matter. Everyone needs a family dynamic. Everyone needs and wants that. Technically, I believe that's the main reason why everybody's just turning gay. Everyone's realizing certain things. Everyone's realizing, you know, their bisexuality. Just a lot is going on. Y'all already know. Y'all see this world. Well, again, I'm not ashamed of it anymore. But I'm glad to find out this part of myself because it has helped me greatly just know a lot of it. It has helped me learn a whole lot more about myself. Now I know why I've done certain things over the years, why I feel a certain way, why I haven't really bonded with my husband in a certain way until I admitted the fact that I want to have sex with a woman. I'm gonna stop rambling now because I gotta get these kids up and feed them lunch. And yeah. I've also been a lot happier lately because I did find a friend. Ever since coming out with this, even though she's been on my Facebook list for a long time anyway. But I just now started really talking to her and she's been wonderful, very wonderful friend. So, yeah, she's so much like me, it's scary. We have so much in common, it's like literally fucking scary. Like, I can't even explain to y'all how much in common we have. But yeah, I'm very happy over that. I'm very happy to find this out about myself. Because honestly, I thought it was gonna ruin my marriage, but it isn't. It's actually made us closer. So yeah. Again, I'm gonna stop rambling because y'all probably don't care anymore. If you've watched this video this long, I'm glad you did. Yeah. I'm going to make another video soon. I don't know when. I'll be making more videos. If you guys have any questions or comments or whatever, leave them down below. And I'll talk to you guys whenever I can. Whenever I'm not so busy. So, yeah.
You're so cute. Hey, little baby girl. Oh, I love you, baby girl. Look at little Kayana. Hey, Kayana.
I wanna take a-